Of all the web-based AI coding applications out there, Lovable has been the most feature-rich and easy-to-use platform. And they just released a few new updates. If you go to Twitter, this is their post, which says, "Introducing versioning 2.0 to Lovable. Restore earlier versions of your app more easily by using bookmarks and our improved history view." The restore option was always there, but this is slightly better now. So bookmarks, so you have this button here, you can just click on that to remember something. So for example, we have a certain version which you feel like, okay, this is important. We've just added one feature here. So it's better to click on that button so that we can figure out that this particular thing is there. Easier restores. Restores to an old edit. Now create a new edit card, making everything easier to track and manage in the chat history. Redesign history. Our previous history tab could quickly get cluttered as project grows in number of edits. The improved history now groups edits by date, just like Google Docs, making it easier to keep organized. Let's look at these new features in the app itself. If I go to an older project that I've been working on, this is a screen recorder software which has automatic zoom and pan. This didn't exactly work out as I expected. So for example, if I just start recording here and select this entire screen and start sharing, so you can see the zoom is happening. It doesn't really, but it does happen as you can see in the preview window here. And if I stop it, save that and open that video, you can see that this is actually scaled up. This whole video is kind of zoomed in and it's not moving. So whatever zooming in effect you were seeing here was only in the preview, not really in the output. And I kind of got stuck at this point, and no matter what prompts I was giving it, it would just not get out of this particular problem. And I tried to go back and because this restore button was always there, so I clicked on it and it was not really doing it. And on top of that, the biggest problem was I didn't know which was the version which had a proper working version. So that is where I think this particular button here, the bookmark button, would be very, very helpful. So if I just go back to a particular version, let me go back to this. So if I just click on this one, so saved in history. And if I just go to the history, you can see that this is saved here. So it has the date and time. And if I want to, I can click on that and then click restore this version. So we've just restored to an older version of this application. I've been working with Cursor a lot, and this restore button has saved me so much, because sometimes the AI makes a mistake and then you keep prompting, trying to make it work. But the fundamental error that was caused is just repeated again and again and again. And that error is not getting corrected because it's not able to find what was that first error that was caused, right? So it's better if you have a version, working version, go back to it. So whenever you have fixed a problem or added a feature, just make sure that you click on that bookmark button so that you can figure out which is a good version that you can always go back to when something goes wrong, okay? And not just that, there are a lot of other features that has been added. So if you go back to the chat window here, you have this button here, which is code viewer. Now you can toggle that button to see all the code. You don't have to connect it to GitHub to see the code. So you can now see the code. If you want to edit the code, you can do it, but you need to have a pro version for this one. Otherwise you'll get this message, read only. So that's another new feature that has been added. Sometime back, they had actually added something called edit. This edit button here, this is actually very, very useful. A lot of the time what happens is that just for a small design change, especially for someone like me, I care about design so much. And I do care about certain padding, certain margins, the gap between a certain two elements and stuff like that. It genuinely matters to me. So this feature, if you just click on edit, and then go to the preview window and select whichever element you want. You can, all of these elements can be individually selected. So let's say I'm going to select this button here, and that brings up the properties of the button here. And let's say I want to increase the vertical padding for that button. I'm going to increase it like this. Look at that. Now the height of the button has been increased, right? If I want to change the color, let's say select something like this, or if I want to try something crazy, I do have the option to do this, or I can go to custom and then select the color I want to use. Okay, so that option is there now, and then you can click on save to actually save that edit that you just did. So right now, these are the updates that has been released. And on Twitter, they had mentioned that custom domains are coming to Lovable, which is very, very exciting as well. So I just wanted to make a quick video on these updates. If you'd like to watch more AI related content, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.